Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Jenny. I'm from Gina K Designs. My YouTube channel contains content that is intended to share paper crafting tutorials and inspiration with all of you. All of the products featured in my videos are intended to share my ideas and information with you using the products that I know and love and have purchased with all of my own money. None of this content is sponsored or paid for by anyone other than me. These are solely my own ideas and inspiration. I hope that you enjoy. Today's video, we're going to be making the perfect rainbow blends with Gina K inks. So I've got a large selection of inks here, some of my favorite colors, and as we use them, I will name the colors that we're using so that you can create your own rainbow after. And I have some tailored expressions blending brushes here. I've got a piece of Gina K Designs 120 pound pure white luxury cardstock, and let's start. So I'm taking my Tailored Expressions blender brush and I'm rubbing it into my ink pad and then I'm coloring my paper. So we're going to go in rainbow order here, and the colors for the ink will be listed on screen for each one that I use. And I just go back and forth with my blending brush, and sometimes I go back to the previous color to get a nice blend between the two colors if I find that it's not very smooth. And this is starting to look very vibrant. And I also want to mention one of the things that I'm working on is a silicone baking mat. This baking mat is just something that I bought from Amazon, and it holds my paper in place. So I paid $20 Canadian for an extra large baking mat, and it holds my paper and I don't have to stick my fingers inside of the wet ink to hold it in place or move it around. And I think it just works out really great for ink blending. So we're on the final color here. I'm just going to fill up that little corner with pink. Here is a look at the finished rainbow background. What's better than one rainbow? How about two? A double rainbow. So this one's going to be a little bit different. The colors will be a little bit more softer and not as vibrant, as well as the orientation that I ink up the background. So I've got the same 120 pound piece of Gina K Designs cardstock, and I'm just kind of going in like a circular sort of motion, kind of thinking of each section as like a slice of a pie essentially. So that's how I'm inking up this piece of cardstock. So we'll just go through this and blending back and forth. Sometimes I go back, I pick up the previous color and blend the two together. So also one of the things that's great about using a silicone baking mat is that you can pick the ink back up off of it. So if there's any ink on the mat, you can use your brush to reapply it to the paper. So here's a look at the finished project. So now we're going to take these backgrounds and make some cards with them. Okay, with the first background, I'm going to take my anti-static powder bag and just pat this all over my cardstock, and then we'll pull in the Misti, and I've got a Gina K Designs red rubber background stamp, and I'm going to ink up this stamp with my Gina K Designs clear sticky ink, and I'm going to press down really firmly. So once I'm happy with the impression, then I will go ahead and I'll sprinkle some white embossing powder over top of my background. And this is just white embossing powder that I have in a tray on my desktop. So I'll heat this up until it's all smooth and melted, making sure that your heat gun is nice and hot so that we avoid warping. We'll clean off the stamp and move to the second background. Again, doing the same thing, anti-static powder bag all over my cardstock, and then slip it into the Misti. And this time I've got the Diagonal Stripes by Gina K Designs, and I'm going to ink it up with the Obsidian Black Amalgam ink. I really like this dark black ink, so I inked it a few times to make sure I got a good solid impression. And the ink is still a little bit wet, so if we do it quickly, then we still have time, we can emboss with this. So I inked it up, I think, three times total, and then take my clear embossing powder and sprinkle it over this background. So we'll heat this up until it's all smooth and melted, and I won't hold my embossing gun in one spot for too long so I don't burn the powder. And then I'm going to take this over to my Tim Holtz trimmer, and I'm going to trim these backgrounds up. I'm going to save all of those scraps off to the side of my screen there on the right, and I'll show you a bonus project at the end with those scraps. So I'm just trimming these up. I'm going to put the white embossed background on a white card base, and I'm going to put the black embossed background on a black card base. Okay, I'm going to use some white craft foam, and I'm going to put that behind my panels. I like the even raised dimension that it gives. I like the feel of my cards when there's craft foam in behind my panel. So I'm going to glue those down, and I'll just use my Misti as a little bit of weight to hold the panels down while they adhere to the card base. And I'll do that to both of my panels, exact same thing, craft foam, glue, Misti, and then move on to the sentiments. I'm using the large word sunshine and the small font you are my from this little tiny stamp set sunshine, and I'm going to stamp that with the obsidian amalgam ink again. And I don't want anything too drastic. I just want a simple basic sentiment because I want the backgrounds to do all of the work. So I'm stamping this down on a little piece of white cardstock for the white card, and then I'll stamp with clear sticky ink and white embossing powder for the black card base. So I'll trim up those sentiments and get them adhered down to my panel. I stamped the words you are on a small piece of black cardstock and then heat embossed it with white embossing powder, and then put a little slip of craft foam in behind that and pop that up on my panel. And then I've got this super awesome collection of jewels here. This is a container from Michaels. I really love the color assortment in this. It's so awesome. And you can just dig through these forever and have tons of different jewels to accent your projects. So here's a close-up look at the finished cards. I really, really, really love this card design. It's probably one of my most favorite cards that I've made in quite some time. And then I've got just a photo here. I didn't record the process, but I've got a bonus project for you here. This card was made with just the scraps and leftover bits and pieces from these panels. And I really love the way that it turned out. I just die cut a little heart from my stash and some sentiment strips that I had lying around and glued it on top. And it just really came together as a beautiful looking card. Okay, so that's it for this video. Thank you so much for stopping by to spend some of your time with me here today. I truly appreciate all of the support. If you like this video, click that like button and hit the subscribe button if you haven't subscribed already. I'd love to have you along my card making journey. That's it for today. So have a wonderful day, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye!